In this lesson, we are going to focus on how to simplify natural logarithmic with a. Now, you need to know that when a log has a base a log becomes a natural log. For example, if we have log base a raised to the power of 6, this is the natural log of 6 or the natural logarithmic of 6. As you can see, the base is a, so when a log has a base, the log becomes a natural log. And you need to know that e is a number. E is equal to 2.718. So natural log only have base a. So let's take a look at an example. Let's say we want to evaluate ln or the natural log of e raised to the power of a. This is going to be equal to 1 because, as you can see, we are having the base as a, which is the natural log. We're having the base as a, and this is raised to the power a. So because we have e at the base and we also have e at the power, so these are going to cancel out. So the e are going to cancel out, so we are now left with 1. So the natural log of e raised to the power of a is equal to 1. So let's take a look at another example. Let's say we want to evaluate the natural log of e raised to the power of 10. Now, how can we evaluate this? What we are going to do is, we are going to take the 10, we are going to move this 10. We are going to move this 10 forward. So this is going to be 10 multiply ln of e, which is 10 multiply the natural log of e. Like we all know, natural log of e is always equal to 1. So this is going to be 10 multiply 1, which is equal to 10. So this is the answer. So let's take a look at another example. Let's say we have e raised to the power of ln of 20. How can we evaluate this? What we are going to do is, we are going to say this is e raised to the power of ln of e raised to the power of 20. So this is e raised to the power of the natural log of 20. As you can see, e is going to cancel out a. So we are now left with ln of 20. So this is basically going to be equal to 1 because the natural log of e is always equal to 1. So this is 1 multiply 20, which is going to give us 20. So this is the answer. So what about e raised to the power of ln of e, then multiply s raised to the power of 5. Now how can we evaluate this? As you can see, the e are going to cancel out. So this is going to be equal to s raised to the power of 5 because the natural log of e is always 1. So this is 1 multiply s raised to the power of 5, which is going to give us s raised to the power of 5. Now what about e raised to the power of 20, then multiply ln of s. Now how can we evaluate this? So this is going to be e, then raised to the power of ln multiply y raised to the power of, sorry, not y, s, multiply s raised to the power of 20. What I did is, I took this 20, I moved this upward. So instead of having 20 multiply ln of s, it is now ln of s then raised to the power of 20. You can do this. This is basically one of the law of logarithmic, so you are allowed to do this. So you can basically move 20, you can move this to the power. So this is going to be e raised to the power of ln of s, then raised to the power of 20. Now, as you can see, this is e raised to the power of ln of a, which is going to give us 1 because natural log of e is always equal to 1. So this is 1 multiply s raised to the power of 20. So this is going to give us s raised to the power of 20. So this is the answer. Now let's take a look at one more example. So let's say we want to evaluate ln of 1 divided the square root of a. How can we evaluate this? We know that this is ln of 1 divide the square root of a. This is basically e raised to the power of 1 over 2. So this is going to be equal to ln of, we can write 1 over e raised to the power of 2. If we take the reciprocal, this is basically e raised to the power of negative 1 over 2. Now we can move negative 1 over 2. We can move this to the front. So this is going to be negative 1 over 2, then multiply ln of e. And what is ln of e? Ln of e is basically 1, because natural log of e is always equal to 1. So this is negative 1 over 2, then multiply 1. So this is going to give us negative 1 over 2. So this is going to be the final answer. So this is how we can simplify natural logarithmic with e.